Perhaps I can assist you.
You followed me?
Prompted by idle curiosity. Does this writing interest you? Allow me to... Hark now, hear the words. Heaven's path is the way of prayer. Bow low and worship their goddess. Wings borne on sacred air. There is more, but the letters are worn away.
That's enough. Wings borne on sacred air. I think I have that covered and...
The angel's master.
This looks like a relic from ancient times. I wonder if it's something to do with the Grail of Valhalla. Keep searching.
Fragments you collected from Heaven's Path are artifacts of ancient origin. Heaven's Path is the road that leads to the Sacred Grail. However, from these few examples, I cannot tell you the significance of the shards.
Just broken shards. I've got a nice collection of shards, but I'm no closer to the Grail.
At last.
I have. All I found were these broken shards.
Exactly! The shards scattered along Heaven's Path are themselves the remains of the Sacred Grail. All that remains now is for me to restore the treasure to what it once was. There. The Grail of Valhalla. Here it belongs to you. Finally, I have achieved what I set out to do. My real objective was to find the true vessel.
The true vessel?
I understand now. The Grail of Valhalla is said to be filled with the divine grace of the goddess herself. But it is not a man-made object. It is a living thing. The person who has inherited the goddess's grace. You see now, don't you? Just as I am the safekeeper of the scriptures, the vessel that keeps the sacred wisdom safe. You, who can navigate Heaven's path, are the vessel that contains the Etro benediction. You are the true grail of Valhalla. Thank you. You have shown me the truth. The truth that I devoted my life to finding.
Me? A vessel for the grace of a goddess? No, it doesn't make any sense. No, it can't be. Even if my heart was big enough for such a thing, I don't feel anything there. If I am a vessel, I am an empty one.
As long as Sarala takes over the field, I'll be okay. I'll take Gasol greens over Tantal greens any day.
Tantal?
Tantal greens. The folk over at the Chaos Research Camp grow them. They're a fine legume, but not as good as Gasol greens, in my opinion. But pay them a visit, if you're interested.
Chocobo is looking fit as a fiddle. I think you'd make a wonderful chocobo vet. I feel like I've been living my whole life just to see this happen. I really can't tell you how grateful I am. To tell you the truth, I only became Dr. Gazal's assistant because I had a crush on Seven. They put me in charge of a chocobo. I had no idea what I was doing, so I peppered poor Seven with questions constantly.
Wonderful. He's almost fully recovered.
Huh. What is it? Huh. Is that right? You're feeling just like your old self again, are ya? I'm glad to hear it.
He's made a complete recovery. Well done, Lightning. The Angel of Valhalla is fit and ready to fight again. It's all thanks to you.
Dr. Ghazal had more to do with it than anyone. He's been learning about the Chocobo for more than a century. It's a good reminder of what people can do when they care enough and work together.
Yes. If you say so.
He's recovered at last. Look at him. He is the true angel in all his glory. For 100 years, nay, for longer than that, I have dreamed of the day that I would see the true angel. His destiny is to guide you to the goddess's temple, a temple that emerges from the side of a mountain, its entrance beyond the reach of any man. But this chocobo will catch the wind, and on wings of white, he will bear you across the crevices to that distant, forsaken place. Such a majestic animal I have never seen. On tireless legs, he can run for days. Now he's ready to serve you. My 100-year quest has come to an end.
What the other researchers are doing.
A traveler. Well, this is a rare treat.
This place is off the beaten track.
Let me tell you something. This used to be the center of civilization. It might be hard to believe, but up until a few centuries ago, this land was home to the world's largest city.
Yeah, a long time ago, right?
Yeah, that's right. And then the chaos came and devoured everything. Soon after, I set up camp here with my colleagues to research the dark power that swept over this land. No one's been keeping track of how long we've been out here, but it's been a while. We've been preoccupied, buried in our work, though we've made little progress. That Chocobo is the rumored Angel of Valhalla, isn't he? The Chocobo of Legends. Now that I've seen him for myself, he does look rather regal.
He's a lot more than regal.
Oh, no offense. I know he's a creature of destiny, fated to lead his ordained master to the truth.
So you know something about this legend?
Of course. My team and I have been in this mysterious land for many years. We call this the Omega Point, the origin of the chaos that erupted and spread throughout the land over 500 years ago. It appears the source of the chaos is rumored to be hidden somewhere inside the Temple of the Goddess, out here in the Wildlands. We were sent out here to investigate the Omega Point, but because of the rocky terrain, there are still areas we haven't been able to reach. Unfortunately, the Goddess's temple is one of them.
But now that the Angel of Valhalla has decided to grace us with his presence...
Exactly. With those wings, there's no doubt he can take you there. Many old remains have been discovered in this area. That's the wreckage of an airship that fell to the ground after getting sucked into the chaos. If only we could gather data from the wreckage, I'd be willing to bet it would be an enormous help to our research.
It might help you solve the mystery of what happened back when the world first started to fall apart.
That's right. I can't promise we'll discover every last detail of what happened, but it would get us closer to the truth.
Every piece of the puzzle is important.
I appreciate that. This device extracts data from objects. When you find something, all you need to do is activate it. Once the device reaches its capacity, the light will flash, letting you know it's full.
How many pieces of debris?
It varies by location and situation, but I'd estimate that 4 would probably do the trick out here.
You see that old husk of an airship over there? There's a grumpy old guy who lives there. I'd keep your distance if I were you. He almost never comes out. He didn't used to get any visitors, but lately I've seen some young girl coming and going.
Hi! Hello there!
You're Dr. Ghazal's assistant.
Tilda, I'm a doctor around here. We have a bit of a problem, I'm afraid. So I was just consulting with the assistant here.
He doesn't look happy.
Something is wrong, that's for sure. We just found him. He's ever so weak.
Oh, poor thing. But he'll be all right, with a vet and a doctor looking after him.
Right. This clever vet was just telling me about an effective medicine. That should help.
I'm still just a trainee. Dr. Ghazal is the clever one, but I'm going to help this little one get better.
He'll stay with me for the first little while. Not that I know much about dogs. I usually treat people, obviously. All I need to do is have him drink the assistant's medicine. I can handle that.
Good news for the dog. I'm sure he'll get better soon.
He would, except...
Except...
Well, we're out of ingredients.
Yeah, that's the problem, see?
I could collect the ingredients for you.
Yes, you could. The assistant can give you a list of what we need.
Oh no, I'm not. I still hardly know anything at all. He just needs the right medicine and he'll be fine.
Okay then, tell me what you need. And I should give these to Tilda, right?
Yes, please. Well, I've got to run. Dr. Ghazal will be expecting me back at Canopus Farms.
Thank you. The world is being consumed.
Did you know there's a weird fellow who lives in the remains of that downed airship?
Is this it? Sazh?
Leave us alone.
What are you doing here? Dash, is he asleep?
Yeah, he's been like that for centuries. Silent as death. Ever since the chaos came and destroyed everything. His body's still alive, but his soul? It's not in there.
What's that?
It's a coffer of souls. If I can collect enough soul fragments, Dash will wake up. At least that's what I was told. Yeah, it'd just be a lie, though.
Who gave it to you?
Lumina. Enough talk. I gotta look after my son.
Hope, you've gotta be able to find something about Dash's condition. Sazh is... I can't let him go through this.
I know, Lightning. I was listening too. I'll look into it. Physically, he seems fine, but I detect no mental activity. Not even dreams.
My goodness me, if it isn't the Savior. Fancy meeting you here.
Don't go acting all sweet and innocent, Lumina. I know it's no coincidence that you're here.
Oh, so you think that I'm lurking around here, hiding poor little Dash's soul. Is that it?
Something like that.
Nope. Though you're right that it's no coincidence. I'm here because I've been keeping an eye on you. I'm just so worried about whether you'll be able to save Sazh.
Save Sazh? What about Dash?
Whatever. You can save both, if you'd really like. But you must have noticed that dear Daddy's soul is getting crushed, right, Savior?
I don't even know if the coffer of souls that Lumina gave Sazh can really help him. But poor Sazh will do anything if it might bring Dash back. Even searching for soul fragments.
I want to do something to help, but I don't know where to start. I should have pushed Sazh to tell me more, but the state he was in, he might not have been able to. Thank you.
for dinner.
The ground looks right for planting. I can grow vegetables. If you have some room in your field, I'd like to use a patch.
This is private property.
If you have some room...
You're not allowed here.
Did you come from Canopus Farms? It's been weeks since I ate a fresh vegetable.
Thank you so much. All right, little dog. It's time to drink your medicine. This'll fix you up. Gosh, will you look at that? This stuff works fast. Claudia will be so pleased.
Claudia? Who's that?
Who's that? Why, Dr. Gazal's assistant, of course. You met her earlier. Oh, wait. You know her as 13. Is that right? Ugh, that Dr. Gazal. I don't know why he can't be bothered to learn people's names. Claudia is a wonderful assistant. Well, quite good anyway, and she deserves more respect. And when she's not sure about something, she always checks with the other assistant. Well, anyway, the dog is safe and sound. If you happen to run into Claudia again, let her know for me, would you?
Sure.
Oh, and here, I've got some leftover medicine.
What's happening over at Canopus Farms?
Mighty strange. Never heard of anything like that before.
You running off to Luxarian?
Ran off, more like it.
I'm detecting large infusions of chaos in the area. They're all over Canopus Farms.
Why would chaos suddenly appear across a single village like that? I have to check it out. What is it?
It's the chocobos, the ones I'm treating. They're inside the chaos.
Doctor, it's too late.
Did all the villagers make it out okay?
Yes, everyone is accounted for.
I saw something in there. It was a chocobo eater. If we don't get those chocobos to safety fast, they'll be slain, every last one of them.
You want to help your fellows, is that it? I didn't need to ask.
I've analyzed the chaos. The monster inside is too large to be a chocobo. I can only assume that it's a chocobo eater.
Am I too late?
I've never seen a chaos infusion like this. The enemies are covering a large area. It's not losing.
Together, we can do this. Thanks for waiting. we meet again. Don't even try. Didn't appear naturally. Some something has brought it here deliberately.
I think the Chocobo Eater is the source of the infusion. You have to defeat it to get rid of this chaos.
Dr. Gazal! Carrot!
Together, we can do this.
Ah!
strikes. Forgive me. I couldn't do it. I couldn't save your friends. I can do this. Let me pray for them. It's no substitute for salvation. But at the very least, perhaps I can give them peace. Odin! My friend. You have to know, I am powerless. I couldn't save all the souls who yearned for salvation. With each failure, I grew more despondent. But even in my despair, I kept fighting. The bond we had, it transcended centuries. No matter how much we changed, I always felt your strength. Even in my darkest hours, you made me strong. Good news from Tilda. That dog she found is doing much better.
He is? Well, that's great.
The medicine you prescribed was exactly what he needed. You're a fine vet, Claudia.
You know my name? And you remembered it? Oh, this is so embarrassing. Anyway, I appreciate the praise, but I don't know anywhere near as much as Seven does, and practically the only thing Dr. Ghazal says to me is, "Hey, 13.
I wonder why he still won't call you by your proper names.
Oh, he says it's because he can't be troubled to learn them. But really, I think it's because he doesn't want to get too close to us. He's cared for a lot of people and animals over the years, and most of them have gone one way or another. He must be so tired of losing people he's grown fond of.
Yeah, it's hard to say goodbye to people you love. To keep everyone at a distance is one way to protect yourself.
That said, in my case, I think it really is because he can't remember my name. I'm still so hopeless at everything, and I've still got so much to learn. A number is all I deserve.
No, that's not true.
Hey, 13! Get over here!
See what I mean?
Are you deaf? Come over here, Claudia. I need your advice.
Go on.
Coming!
like you have a cute little admirer. I think she senses you saved her life.
She's not scared of people. Maybe she was a pet.
Yes, that could very well be the case. Usually the ones that live in the wild aren't so friendly.
If she does belong to someone, then...
What is it?
I just remembered a woman that I met, out on the trail near Canopus Farms. She was upset and told me that she had lost her dog.
We still call ourselves a research team. Wait, don't tell me. You want me to make more medicine for your own use. You're going to have to pay me, though.
Again. How is he?
Not great. Not great at all. He's so focused on this one thing, he can barely think about anything else.
Well, he has a right to be. Dash has been asleep for centuries. You can tell, can't you, that I'm terribly worried about them too. I wish I could help, but he would never ever ask me to. And sadly, he'd never let me.
I heard the reason Dash can't wake up is because his soul has left his body. Is that true?
It is. And not only that, it's been shattered into 5 fragments and scattered all over the world! That's what Sazh is working so hard to collect, the fragments!
So, when all 5 pieces are located, will he wake up?
Yes, indeedy! Oh, you also need a coffer of souls, but I think Sazh already has one. Lucky for you! The one and only way you can help him is to find all 5 fragments! What a wonderful present that would make!
Thanks for telling me all this. I don't think I could have dragged this out of Sazh. Not the way he is now.
I'm just happy to be of help! Oh, I almost forgot to tell you! I've already found one of the fragments all by myself! It's the one called the Smile Fragment. I know it's something that Sazh needs, but it's not really an item per se. So, I can't give it to you to give to him on my behalf.
How do you propose you get it to him then?
With this magically spectacular canvas of prayers. Take a look, and you'll find what you need. Come on now, time's a-wasting!
Yes?
Remember telling me about your family?
I do, but I don't have family anymore. Like I told you, my darling Clove just ran away. What? Clove? Clove, is that really you? It is! Where have you been? I thought you were dead! I'm so glad you're back safe and sound! I am never, ever letting you out of my sight again.
moguls around here?
Are you busy?
Very busy, Koopo.
Koopo, Koopo.
Koopo, Koopo.
Onto a small village, the last home of the Mughals. I was just in time. Their peaceful lives were about to be shattered by a terrible menace. You mean them?
Yes, Koopo.
Terrible beasts they are. They must hurt us poor Mughals, Koopo. Ow, ow.
And now they know where you live.
You did it! You got rid of the monsters that were terrorizing the Moogles. That ought to be a weight off their minds. You should let them know right away.
What's all the noise for, Koopa? Some of us enjoy a little peace. It's the Chief Koopa!
The Grand Poobah, Koopa!
Where have you been, Koopa?
You can't really be. You're still alive? Mog, it really is you, isn't it?
Koopa, Koopa! Lightning! What?
Hey, come back! Mog, it is you, isn't it?
Who's Mog, Koopa?
What are you playing at? Is it that terrible having to see me again?
No, Koopa, I swear!
Then turn around.
Mog does not deserve to look Lightning in the eye, Koopa.
Oh.
Because Mog couldn't protect Sarah, Koopa. And so...
Mog.
Koopa!
I'm glad you're all right. I was worried about you. I know what you're feeling. You've shed a lot of tears for Sarah, haven't you?
Koopa.
But blaming yourself for what happened is just gonna make her sad. You know that.
Sarah's gone, Koopa. Gone forever.
Her soul is still out there. And I promise you, I'm going to bring her back.
Really, Koopa?
Really. So listen, I need a very important favor from you.
Koopa Popo?
There's a chance that I won't be around to meet her when she returns. I'm gonna try not to let that happen. But if it does, I want you to be there instead. She'll need someone she knows and loves waiting for her. Don't give up. Things are going to get better. Did they disappear?
10 days ago, Koopa. Can you help?
Ten days? Shouldn't you have started searching for them already? Where did they go missing?
I don't know, Koopa, but they are not brave. I don't think they would venture out of the forest, Koopa.
Well, I suppose that narrows it down. But how can a Moogle get lost in the first place? You can all fly, right? Just take to the air, and you can find the trail from above.
You're exactly right! That's a great idea, Koopa! Why didn't any of us think of that before? We always flutter close to the ground, Koopa. To soar in the sky? I scarce imagine it!
Really? Seems like common sense to me. You can fly that high, right?
Of course, Koopa. It's just scary to go too high.
Never mind. Anyway, I'll look for your friends.
You will? Oh, thank you!
Thank you, Kubo.
All right, got it.
You found a soul fragment for me. I owe you one, Lightning, and so does Dodge. Have I gotta depend on that chocobo lady then? Get down on my knees and beg. You. You're one of the lost Moogles, aren't you?
It's true. I want to go home, but I don't know the way, Kubo.
If you flew up above the treetops, you'd be able to find your village easily enough.
Above the treetops, Kubo? Except I'm afraid of heights, Kubo.
It's all right. I'll give you a hand. Do it.
He's fine. I made a quick cut.
Let's do this, Odin!
But trust me, this isn't the end of anything.
Koopa? Will you turn me into a star?
I'll get you home. Faster than you think.
Thank you.
See that? That there is a cluster of barrier vines. The blue ones part during the day.
To me. I'll get you home.
What are you? Koopa!
You found a soul fragment. Have I gotta depend on that joke?
Your three friends here, and then make sure it doesn't happen again. If any more of your brothers go missing, you're gonna have to find them from high up in the sky where I throw you. Got it?
Please, not the sky, Koopa.
let my brothers go astray again, Kubo. I'll watch them with eagle eyes, Kubo.